great singer.
He's listening to you. He's listening to you.
It's Judy Morton.
He knows every heart that you're.
She sang with the Heritage Singers. I think when they first started, in 71. She passed away a few years ago. And her mom was a singer too, Seventh-day Adventist, back in the 40s. Both mother and daughter were known for their octave levels. I'm sitting here at Stewart Peninsula Park, which is just a couple of streets over from where we live. It's where I golf, practice my golf, but it's raining. So I thought I'd come and sit and talk to God, and maybe the rain will stop. Maybe it won't. Take time to talk to God between you and Him. He likes to commune with you. He wants to commune with you. Make time for Him. Get to know Him. Study the Bible. Read Ellen White's book, Desire of Ages, and you'll never be the same person again. I promise you, you'll never be the same person. I've probably read it 3 times. Great controversy, read about end times, the churches, the Protestant reformers, what heroes they were. God raised up the Protestant Reformation. And He has His people in every church, including Catholics, of course. I'm not talking about people, I'm talking about an organization, a hierarchy, an ecclesiastical organization. And that's the difference. Either you have a relationship with your church or you have a relationship with your Savior. One stresses the church and tradition. The other stresses the Savior and the Word. One is a religion of works like Cain, and the other is a religion of Abel, the blood. You know, in her book, Patriarchs and Prophets, she talks about Cain and Abel. She says they represent the two end time classes of people. One is a religion of works. Abel brought the blood of the sacrifice, and he was acceptable. Cain's was not. No church tradition, and I include any church, Seventh-day Adventist church included, Lutheran, Catholic, any other religion that depends on your own efforts to be made right with God is not going to be acceptable in the judgment. God has to see the blood. And that comes through a relationship that Jesus knows you and you know Him. He should be first in your life. My mom used to say that. And He was first in her life. Even before your family. Even before your children. Because He gave you your children. See what song this is. I love the way she sings. The King is coming. The rain is down to a little, not even a sprinkle, almost a mist. I can hit golf balls in this if I wanted to. Isn't that beautiful? Carla's in San Francisco. She's up there by Doug Batchelor's church, literally minutes away. I said you should stop by and say hi to Pastor Doug. She's near Roseville. And then she has to go to San Francisco. Normally I'd try to go with her, but we're getting our house done. Got some watermelon. Got some new golf shorts. Broken homes that he has mended. Those from prison. Pray for Pastor Carter and his team. And Susie. I love to get letters from Susie P. Rhino. Such great memories at their home. Susie and Javier, the greatest church hosting couple I've ever seen in my life. Their family, their sons. One's a doctor. I don't know what Patrick does. They're not only good parents, good hosts, good disciples, good servants, and I'm sure they're invaluable to Pastor Carter. We love Pastor Carter. He sent us a message. I haven't looked at it yet because I don't have a CD drive, so I need to get one. Computers don't come with them anymore. So if you're listening, Pastor Carter, man, we miss you and your church, and we pray for you. We, you know, we try to support you, and I know you don't want to hear any of this. I get that, but you're a vessel for God, and you answered the call. You changed so many lives. You baptized so many people. I think you're the greatest evangelist of our day, of my day. I know HMS Richards was a previous generation. And you preach prophecy in the gospel, you know, the days at Glendale and Arcadia. Those were the days. And Susie and Javier, and going to church every Sabbath with Jessica and Ashley, his little girls. Those are irreplaceable days. They cannot be matched or till we get to heaven. And I know you have people you want to see. We all do. Of course, first is the Lord, because he makes everything possible. And then our loved ones. And for us, it's Jess. It's Jess. And Ashley graduated from Southwestern Adventist, and she just started with the Frisco School District. Frisco is, I can't tell you how great Frisco is as a city here in North Texas. Probably the fastest growing. It's where the Dallas Cowboys have their new training center, the PGA. Oh, I like this song. Remember the Heritage Singers sang at the Carter Report one Saturday, Sabbath afternoon. And then they had the Heralds. Max Mace. I think he was inspired, a lot of his music, in him. Heritage Singers sing a lot about the Second Coming. I don't want to hear any good advice, and I don't want to hear any good psychobabble. I want to hear about the return of Jesus Christ so we can be with him. How you be happy if you're not with him? How can you be happy if you're not with your Lord that you love so much? It's like separated. There's no joy in separation, whether it's loved ones or God. That's why we long for that day. Paul said, blessed are those that love is appearing. Well, it stopped raining here. It's been floods in Dallas. And I think maybe some people died. I know one Uber driver did. Very sad. It was the largest single day of flooding, I think, in Dallas history yesterday, or second. We were about 20 minutes north of Dallas, and we got a lot of rain, but not like Fort Worth and Dallas. So I think I'm going to go out and hit golf balls now. God bless. Susie and Javier, I'm going to send this to you. Maybe you can send it to Pastor Carter because he's been so kind enough to send us so many messages. Man, we love you all. And Carla and us, we just miss you. And the days when Chuck and my mom and the girls go to church every Sabbath, we heard the best preaching ever in the world. You know, Pastor Carter. And the best people, the best church, the friendliest church ever. Churches here are nice, people are nice, but there was nothing like that church. Nothing. Javier, Salgadi, Susie, so nice. My mom loved you, Susie. My mom she thought you were so pretty and so nice. You invited us to your house so many times. All right, I'm going to put this to YouTube and then I'm going to send it. All right, God bless you all.